First order of business is generally the approval of minutes, but the two select board members who were at the April 16th meeting are not here tonight, so we will table those. Community input?
I was here because I thought Tamara was coming. I was going to support her regarding something on the library, so.
Is that the proposal that she submitted to us?
Yes.
I have not had the occasion to read it.
And I don't know if she's going to be here to go through it with you or not.
She did it last week.
She was here last week.
Is this it? Is this a copy that I can take with me to you?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Well, perhaps if we could take that into consideration and look at it next week, which is fine.
Yeah.
That's fine with us.
Good.
Any other community input? One other thing, I just was thinking from the manager committee point of view, I'd like to be able, would it be better for me to try to arrange with Caroline when we can come before the board to interview you?
Yeah, yes.
Why don't I set it up with Caroline?
Yeah, you know, normally, we've got one. We have one meeting set up, and she would know about her, I think, it's like maybe the 19th with somebody from SRPC.
Okay.
So it'd be better to have it a different night.
Okay. I will talk to Caroline about that and have her help, you know, arrange through you, and we'll do it then.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
That's all I have.
All right, nice to see you, Lori.
Get better.
Thank you.
Bye, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Citizens Bank credit card, please. Supposed to be. Did you check all the folders?
Well, this is what this is.
Could be anywhere.
Yes.
All right, George, are you here for a reason?
Oh, it's here.
Is this on my email?
You're not just going to glow.
No.
And throw your way.
Something quick and easy. I have some parts made to fix a plow this winter, and came in over to my Detroit. Got a PO for $255 in parts, steel fabricating.
I probably should set hand on to me now.
Yeah, that would be great. So are you saying, George, that this is in addition to the other one, or you want to amend first, or what?
I don't think we have a parts made.
This is new.
That was, they never billed us, you're just billing us now.
Oh, I see. You thought if it were under $200, we wouldn't need to have seen it, and that was coming in over to you.
Yeah, it was, there was another part we got afterwards. It's all part of, he did bill me for everything at once.
Yeah, okay. So you didn't use the credit card for it, in other words?
Partially steel fabricators, okay. Purchase order 1386 for partially steel fabricators for plow parts for $255.
I will second that.
Okay.
Do we have any questions? I don't either, so I'll call it. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. And Denise, why don't you sign?
Let me sign.
Please.
Yep, glad to. Okay. Is the date on the side for me to put the date in?
Yes, the date you signed, yes.
Okay.
No, I need the truck lettered at Moe's so I can PO for that. But there is no lettering on the backhoe, so I recommend we put the name of the town on the backhoe also. And it's PO for $600 to do both vehicles.
So where's that coming from, George?
We'll take it out of the
so there's sufficient.
Yeah, well, they'll cover it already.
Okay.
Slide it.
Yeah, it'll be.
Thank you.
Probably be less, a little less than 600, just to cover it.
Okay, so purchase order 1120 for signs by Mo, lettering of the new truck and backhoe for $600 even.
I will second that.
Okay.
I do have a question. Mm-hmm. Is there money in the warrant article to cover the lettering for the truck?
No.
So it's all used up?
That was used up.
Okay. I had to ask.
Right. Right. No, it came in tighter than we expected on the truck, so registered, insured, and we're getting it eventually.
And you don't foresee an issue with the budget?
Oh, no.
Okay, all right.
I know we're way down on salt usage, we're way down on overtime.
Okay.
And, yeah.
Okay.
Now, I have a question, and I don't know how much you want to do tonight. I just got a question on the Sligo Road.
We have to finish this.
All right, let's finish this.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Okay, so it's been moved. I did second that.
Yes, you did.
All those in favor say aye.
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 Okay.
We'll let Denise sign it, then we go.
I think the name should be on back or something, when it's in the public side.
Yeah, yeah.
All right.
Of course, we had flooding.
And that means, though, no, you can't be taking it, you know, to some,
Can't drive it to the other side, side show?
That's right, that's right. I was just being.
A week ago, 2 weeks ago, and that wasn't here, we go, but 2 weeks ago tonight, we had Sligo Road flood over.
Where?
By the Aikman property.
Is that the one near the double culvert?
The one that's a double culvert.
Yeah.
I went down and looked at it again today. I had a contract, come and look at it. What is there an issue with replacing that culvert? Is there, we're not gonna touch the dam. I think we should put a 36-inch culvert in there and eliminate this issue of reoccurrence and closing the road.
Right.
We've already closed it twice and got them here.
Now, is that something that you can do?
I'll need a contract, it needs an excavator, but it's, I'm getting a price on it. We can make that look, and leaving the dam and everything alone, we can put that in ourselves.
All right, let's talk, Denise and I have a little bit of a chat on this, and that I can fill her in on some of the background on this, and you as well. So, the two Sligo Road culverts, the one that's the one lane, nearer to Pinch Hill, and this one here, which is closer to Portland Avenue.
Correct.
It's kind of like one, it's one on top, right? It's not saying it's one on top. It was some kind of jury rig, you know, answer or something.
And this just don't work.
Doesn't work. So those, as far as I know, those are the two remaining culvert issues that we have in the town. We've had Oil Tanner actually provide a study on the one that we were able to reopen as a one-lane road because of the work they did per their recommendation. We, in the budget for fiscal 18, there's about, I don't know, maybe 5,000 that we sort of earmarked for engineering. So part of that was to, one thought was to have Hoyle Tanner come in and take a look at either both or at least the double one, because they've never looked at that one. I shouldn't say never looked at it. Aaron has looked at it, but not from a study point of view, just to say, yeah, I could, you know, one point you're gonna need to do something. So we could check in with Hoyle Tanner.
I think it'd be a good idea.
And ask them to give us a, so normally what happens, two things have to happen. Usually by this time of the year, we've already signed a contract with them. And all it does is it sets out the terms and conditions for any work that they do for us. So it's just the basic terms, but it doesn't commit us to anything. To any projects. And then if a project comes up, they'll identify that as a task and actually put the amounts. But some of the basic terms and conditions of how they operate with us are part of that thing that we sign, usually in April.
Okay.
So what we can do is check in with Aaron, who's been our contact, I assume he would still be there, have him come to us, I think, both with one of these contracts that doesn't cost us anything, and to see if, just to give us a rough idea of what we would want from him. And he may say, look, let me write you the task thing right away. You can just decide. I don't know. But I can at least touch base with him and have him come talk to us and we can see where we go. And we'll let you know when he's coming so that you can be here as well. So that would be a homework assignment, if you wouldn't mind.
See, that is restricted because they put a pipe inside the original ground, which restricted the flow considerably. And then I put a case of the second culvert, which is on top of it, we're already in trouble. It's already running over the road, so. And the guy that did a lot of work for us in Berwick, culvert work and stuff like that, and he figures the same thing as I did about a 36-inch culvert. Would handle that flow and, you know, not damaging the dam that's there and everything, just so the water can actually go where it needs to go.
Here's what we have discovered whenever we start talking about culverts like this and the size of these kinds of culverts, is that there are permitting issues, because they're usually around wetlands.
Right.
And there's
that's what I get, that
this, that, and the other thing, that, and that's why if you have an engineer in firm on your side, they will shepherd you through all of the permits, which is what they did with Partridge Lane, what they did with the drainage at the Lower Mill, Willie Street, and Pine Street. They all needed various kinds of permitting, not even always the same one. So that's why, again, you know, it's helpful to have them on board.
Well, no, and I wouldn't,
but
that,
they're also,
that being a project, I wouldn't even attempt to do without having it looked at.
Right, but there, he will also be amenable to hearing what you might be able to, you and the highway department might be able to offer the project. Because there are things that, you know, we can...
Because I know it's made with granite, there's a lot of granite in there, which could be used on the head walls on both sides to dress it up. So.
See, those are the kinds of things that would be helpful for Aaron to know. So I think if we had an initial conversation here, then we can figure out, you know, we can ask him if he thinks he would like each Hoyle Tanner to issue a task order that we would then look at and see if, you know, it depends on the price tag, it depends on a lot of things.
Right.
Then the question's going to be, when do we do it, right? And how much might it cost?
That's why I had it, I'm getting the price to have it done before we, you know, so we have some ideas.
Yep.
I don't think it's going to be a 2-day project, that's what it's going to take.
Okay, well, again, this will be, it'd be really helpful to have you here with Aaron.
Oh, absolutely.
So that would be great.
Yeah,
all
absolutely.
Right.
Yeah, that's why I wanted to talk about it.
Yeah.
And one other issue, a tree in a cul-de-sac on Stark Vale Circle, half of it's broke off. Can we take the rest of that tree down?
Where is the tree in our right-of-way?
It's in the cul-de-sac, so I'm assuming it's in our right-of-way.
What do you mean, like in interior?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, this is a like a little island in
there? Well, you go down Stark Vale, and then you've got that little cul-de-sac at the end. It's in
it's
that inside the cul-de-sac.
Okay. Well, that should be ours.
Half of it's broke off, and the damage that it caused when it broke, the tree's not going to last. It's half a tree now.
Yeah.
So I just figured we'd just take it right over.
Yep. You're hearing yeses from both of us, so.
Okay. That's just before I cut any trees down, I wanted to make sure
that's
good.
Yeah, absolutely. So we appreciate that, but yeah.
Okay.
Safety is paramount.
Anything for me?
Nope, I don't think so. I am doing first quarter budgeting. It's going slowly because I'm moving as quickly as I would like to be moving. So I may have some questions of you that I could then bring back to the board and stuff. So I actually maybe have left some with Caroline, so we'll...
Yeah.
We can talk about it that way.
And I did get a call. Ed got a call last week from the woman on Church Street about the drainage.
Yes. So we did, okay, we did say we'd kind of look at it in the spring.
He's still draining water out of the basement from the house before it, and that's what's causing the issue.
So somebody is draining...
pumping the cellar into this street in front of the house, and that water is what's causing the whole issue.
Have we checked in with Chief Duchar?
It was in Tom Clark's hands the last I know. He issued... He went over and talked to him and made sure it was taken care of. Of course, it was wintertime then.
There is a public ordinance now
that
we are not supposed to be discharging water into the public way. So why don't you put that on my homework assignment and I'll touch.
I read something, I don't know where I read it, probably it was on Google Drive somewhere, that it said that he had to put it inside drainage or something.
Put it into
his,
yeah.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Nothing's been done, the water's still coming out and that's what's causing that.
Yeah. You know, it's difficult. I mean, it's difficult if you live in the village, because there isn't much place for things, but nonetheless, one household should not be crossing our public ways to deposit water into...
Dumping water in somebody else's property, so...
Yeah, so, I mean, if it were one household to another household, it's sort of a civil matter, but the fact of the matter is they're just charging into...
And it's creating a problem for us.
Yeah, so we'll, I'll send something off, or have Caroline send something off to Chief Ducharme and copy you and Tom, so and us.
I have access right now, my computer's all messed up, they're working on it, so... And I have a storm drain that's collapsed in front of the village vets.
Okay.
We can fix, also.
Yes, okay.
I just want to give you a heads up on it, in case there's some calls up on it. I got a call in there right now, but...
So will you, do you need a PO for supplies?
I don't think it's gonna be that big a deal.
Okay, alright, well, thank you.
I just gotta cut it out and rebuild the cement and bring it up to level again, and then we can pave it in, so...
So that's the responsibility of the town and not the sewer district?
Storm drain.
Okay, so it's the town's responsibility, okay.
It's in the road, right?
Yes.
I'm sorry, I asked if it was the
responsibility of the town, or if it's the responsibility of the sewer and water district.
Oh, it's a storm drain, I suspect.
Correct, that's a storm drain.
Not, yeah, not a sewer drain.
Now, the sewer manholes in Stockdale, we're gonna fix, but we can, now, how can we build this? Greg wants us to help him out.
Okay, whoa, I missed the beginning of this, where...
Because all the manholes in Stockdale Circle are either up too high or breaking, and they wanna fix.
Yes, we've asked them to do that.
Right, well, we can do that.
Okay.
Now, can we build the entity, build them? For materials, and I told them we could do it, as long as we're building for materials, we're not gonna do it for nothing.
That seems like a reasonable thing to do, which is, I would let them know.
Right, and, but that's what I mean, that's why I'm asking you people to be able to do that. I mean, I think it should be something that we can do in town.
I think it would be a nice thing for the town, for town entities to support one another when they can.
And that's what my thought was.
But supplies and stuff is...
Is different, because that comes right out of our...
Right, I mean, it is our road, it's damaged, and it caused problems for us to plow. So that's why offering to do the work part of it.
And...
But they should...
Build that for materials or something.
Yes, and so, how would we convey this? Do we really, do we want George to convey? Do we want one of us to talk to them?
It'd be like an outside contractor to them.
Right.
But not paying labor, so it's a big savings for them.
Yes, so...
And he's gonna work along with us, Ray will.
Yeah.
I would just have him talk to Wayne, just have it be, so they get a good working relationship.
Yeah.
You know?
Perfect.
And I think, you know...
You know, build the materials.
Just tell us materials, I'll have to cover the cost of materials, and they would have had to anyway, whether they bought a contractor in or you use it, so...
And that's the same thing where they had the water break last week. I'm not sure, I haven't talked to them.
And what happened? Was that anything to do with us?
No, no, there's a seven-foot crack in the pipe. Because they found a piece of granite or something on top of the pipe, and frost moving up, and stuff moves. It wasn't properly installed originally, probably not with sand, and... But they apparently found a piece of granite or a rock or something that was right on the pipe, and from frost up and down.
Yeah, they had to...
The crack just kept breaking.
The school had to be discharged, because they didn't have...
Because they didn't have water in the school.
Right.
Is that fixed now? Did that finally get fixed?
That's all fixed. And that's the same contractor that I asked to come and look at. Sligo.
Did they bring the road back to...
The gravel is up, even with the top of it, we'll have to dig it out and bring it down so we can bring the hot... We're gonna let it settle in, compact at the end, and pave it in ourselves. And I'll build them for the hot dog.
Okay.
And I haven't talked to him about that since I've been back, so...
I would talk to him and make sure they are aware of that, because again, that's the materials that...
Right.
Because the understanding we have with them is that while they can work in the roads to do what they need to do, the road has to come back to its, the state that it was in.
Stuff we can do.
Or better.
Sometimes are better.
Stuff we can do, and then put a little bit of money towards other stuff that we need, I mean, you know...
Well, we can't, the money that they give us...
General fund.
It's in the general fund, but it doesn't get augmented to your budget, or anybody else's budget. It's to the good of all of us, but.
Right, but it's still working money for future stuff.
So perhaps, if they could order the supplies, then they, it, that would be the cleanest. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, that would actually, if they could take it.
Well, right, then there's no billing, they can pay for the materials.
Yeah, if you tell them what you need for supplies and let them get it.
We can do that.
And then.
Then we lend it out.
Because otherwise.
They're still saving though.
It's going to come out of the highway department budget.
Yeah, that's true.
So even though there's gonna be revenue to offset it, it doesn't make any difference.
Right, because it's not going in it, right, it's not returned.
It's just, it's one of the things I had to learn very early on in municipal budgeting.
That's fine, we can have them bill it to them.
Yeah, so that would be the best thing.
Yeah, to have them.
We just use.
Have them supply the materials, you supply the labor.
Yeah.
That would be great.
I think that's the cleanest.
Yeah, that's okay, that's what I wanted, you know.
Yeah, no, I'm glad we continue to talk about it.
And I, you know, I'm all for working, I mean, it should work that way.
Exactly.
Yes, and I, we're gratified that you feel that way.
So, because he'll help me, I mean, he helped us out during the snowstorm, he plowed for, he didn't charge us for plowing, he used his own truck and plowed roads for us, so.
Yeah, it's all, you know.
You know, one hand wipes the other.
Exactly. As far as the taxpayer goes, they don't, I mean, they can figure out what part of their tax rate comes from the school or here, but really, it's still, they're still writing a check.
Right.
So anything we could do to make it better for, you know, the residents of the town, that would be wonderful.
Alright.
So thank you, George.
I'll talk with McGray and we'll get things squared away.
Alright.
Have a good night.
Thank you, you too.
You too. Chief Rutherford.
Good evening, Chief.
How are you?
I've been better, I've been worse.
Just one piece of business. One PO, it's to Fire Safety USA, it's number 1340, and it's for some needed equipment we need to put on the for salvage. Short and sweet. It's for covers and tarps, $279.
Okay. Purchase order number 1340, Fire Safety USA, salvage equipment, hall runners and tarps? Is that hall?
Hall.
Oh, okay. Oh, hall is in hauling thing.
Hall is a hall down in the hallway.
Oh, okay, okay. $279 and it's coming out of your equipment fund.
Yes, it
okay.
is.
I will second that. Do we have any questions?
Mm-hmm.
I'll call it then. All those in favor say aye.
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 Just, we don't have any on that engine, and we go to an incident, we need to put down that to cover us tracking in and out, or put salvage cover down to save, you know, we have a fire on the second floor. Can we just attach this pile with that pile so that Caroline will get it? That's just a bunch of other stuff.
Okay.
It's a process for us. That was one thing I needed to get, but then when you asked last week if I needed to do anything, it was alright. The reason why I got down here late last week is we had a meeting with Bill Bartlett from Two Way again about radio communications. That's what's funny thing exactly. But this time we had Chief Ducharme with us, and it was a lot of it was,
okay.
We kind of had the three of us going around because some of this is aimed at the infrastructure improvements to the water tank for the town up here. So we were trying to figure out that. And what Bill Bartlett wanted to do, we kind of said, no, it's not what we're going to do. He wanted us to lose our spot on the tower, and he says, that's not going to happen.
What do you mean, lose your spot?
Where the repeater is up on Garrison Hill Tower.
Yes.
He wanted to take that off of there and put it on the water tank. And he says, that's not happening.
Because? Just curious. I mean, I don't know.
No, the reason why he wanted to do a lot of that stuff is because the height of the tower and where you have your
Which one?
Garrison Hill Tower.
Okay.
And any tower. Really,
right.
Wherever you put your communications equipment on a tower, a lot of it is height dependent on your licensing and being able to get stuff through the FCC. So obviously the higher up you go on a tower, the further and the more power you can exhibit out to wherever. And it's harder to get the proper permitting then.
So it's related to your FCC license.
Correct. Since we already have that spot, it says we're not giving that up. Till when you know what freezes over.
I can guess.
So, with that being said, and he you want to do that, move our, the new fire frequency that we have to the tank, water tank. He says, no. We're taking a step backwards by doing that. And basically what he was trying to do was, in my opinion, not do his total job. We have the grant money, which was procured through PD for the town frequency. That is still going to go in place on the water tank. And that's going to stay on a local channel, which we use now. Basically used between the three entities, the three departments, between the road, the fire, and the police, to augment when we have stuff that we have to take care of in town, you know, a lot of heavy storms or flooding or whatever it's going to be. So that's going to come from there. And we're still going to keep our spot on the hill.
Okay.
That's the reason why I couldn't.
And Chief Ducharme is fine with.
Yeah, he kind of got caught up to speed because some of that stuff, when we did all the switching around, we have to go over kind of, you know, Phillips, you've got to kind of have to. So once we caught up, he didn't quite get the full speed on that, and now he is. And then when the tail end of it came up, we had, like I said, we were at this fire station for 45, 50 minutes discussing how this was going to work and what we wanted to do. So basically, we told him what our parameters were. It's gone back to Bill Bartlett. So he's gone back into his entity over there to try to figure out how this is all going to come together and make it work. So half the infrastructure is there. It's just a matter of finishing the second.
And George is helping, right? Is he trenching?
Correct. He's going to build trench and get power up to the site. And then they get the repeater. We have all the equipment. It's very similar to the equipment we bought from Dover to put up on the tower.
Yeah.
So it's like, we're not going to take a step backwards on that. It's there. It's got a spot. It's staying there for as long as I'm going to be around there. So we got to keep that. So that's what we're doing as far as the radio communication. But again, it's moving forward. And basically what's going to happen with the new stuff that we've purchased and put up on Garrison Hill, and with the stuff from the grant that's going to go up here on the water tower, basically the infrastructure for the community when it comes to radio communications is about as good as can be. As far as not being digital, but anything else that we have, we're right top of the line, and it's going to stay that way for quite a while.
Denise is our rep now on the CIP committee, and so we've talked about making sure that that project gets on the CIP, you know, the going digital.
Oh, okay. All right, I get you on that.
Even though it's down the road.
Even if it's more than 10 years, we'll at least get it on, because there's a way you could talk, you could put a future. I'll show you when the thingy is, when we're ready to get rolling on that.
Yeah.
I can review.
Which I think we should be doing
soon.
In the next month or so. We're going to have our first meeting
of the
year. Get going fast.
Kind of go along with the communication, and the same thing we talked about with portable radios that we need to replace too. Because we run into that all the time, and just before I was leaving tonight, we have what's called a Knox box system in the fire engines.
Mm-hmm.
You're probably familiar with it. There's about 19 places in town, businesses, and there's some private residences. And what it is, you have a box on the side of the building, and within that box is the keys to the building.
Don't we have one here?
Yes, there is one on town hall. You know, like down the mills have them, and Janko has it, the greenhouse has it, and school has it. So if, you know, we get called 2 o'clock in the morning, we can show up, and this box has the keys, as I say, but inside the fire truck we have a code which we punch in, we can open the box, and we have a key which accesses the Knox box. Well, like everything else, the ones that we have are at the end of their service life. So we've been researching through Knox. The Knox company really, you know, gave us the information, says you guys are fine now, they run. That's the same thing we went through with the engine. Next time it breaks or something, we cannot do anything to it. So in the process of replacing those, and that's somewhere around $1,600 to do that. We'll find that within the budget.
So is that for one truck?
That's for two. That's for both. They're $500 a unit.
So how many trucks do you have these in?
Two.
Just two?
The two engines.
The two engines.
$500 a unit, $500 activation fee, and then, you know, the miscellaneous shipping charges and all that stuff. So it comes out to just under $1,600. So I'll figure out where we find that within the budget. It's just the same thing we always run up against.
Mm-hmm.
Just us old. Use it until it goes, but when it goes, you're done. It's the kind of thing where we were discussing, well, maybe we get one. Well, we're going to do one. You got to do them both, because if one of the trucks that has it is in Sanford or Dover or someplace else and we need it, we have an issue. So
you want to make sure that access is this, you know, when you're in a situation of urgency, you don't want to be, you want things to be known, what am I doing, you know, which one is this?
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah, in our business, we can't afford not to have it work.
Right,
it's supposed to work.
Right. Seconds,
exactly,
seconds
right.
Are
yes,
critical.
Critical. So I just want to bring up the other that.
Okay.
All The last piece is, go ahead.
But that was, that's more of a budgetary thing than the CIP, that, that.
Yeah, for $1,600.
I'll find the money in the budget.
That's definitely.
What I'm thinking is, you know.
Online budget.
Yeah, it's a vehicle component, so if vehicle repairs, and we shouldn't have an issue with that. I'm gonna let it go just a little bit till we get a little bit more towards another quarter or two now. When we get into September and trucks are fine, things ain't happening, I know there'll be money sitting there to cover that.
Yeah.
So that's my initial thought.
Yeah, vehicles, repairs and maintenance, so it's perfect.
You going Wednesday?
I'm not, because I'm gonna be at Portsmouth Station Two for a Seacoast Chiefs meeting.
It's gonna be the new 10,000.
I, somebody told me, actually, it was Caroline, because she was looking for, you know, who's gonna go, roster kind of thing. I got another meeting I have to go to that night, I get my monthly meeting, I have to go to the Chiefs things. So I'm down there at that, so if it's, you know, available, I'll get, I'll sit down and get it. And the last thing I have that I wanna just make you aware of is we've got a letter from the ISO, the Insurance Services Organization. You never saw this?
Well, I don't know, I can't, you know, we see a lot of things.
Well, it says forward to me, and I got a packet that I got in the mail, and you remember what ISO was all about?
That's the rating that, is that the rating that?
Yeah. Yeah, and I have the packet. It's just kinda funny, because I got the letter, and there's, the guy's name is Anthony Crescenti, and we've been paying phone tag for a while, but we'll catch up. It's just that they, it says in his letter that they periodically do an update of the community. Well, last time they periodically updated this community was 1993. So I kinda had to chuckle.
Sort of like an eon, period.
Yes, to me, that's not periodically.
No.
So, and as you can see there, has a 6 and a 9, and back in 93, I've been on the fire department just a couple, 3 years. We had so many old trucks, they didn't win any capacity than what we have now, so I should see those numbers, the community should see those numbers move in a more positive direction.
Is up positive or down positive, which, I mean, which is the way?
We wanna go up to one, one is, one being best, nine being worse.
Okay, so we want.
Or a 6 and a 9.
Be a low number.
Yeah, our six is considered in the village area, because we do have water supply, but I just think it's limited, but there is water available. The nine is the rural section of the community, because we have haul water. Well, back when they did that in 93, tanker, as they call it now, which is, you know, hauling water, the biggest one that the fire department had is 1,000 gallons. Well, nowadays, we carry that on the fire, and just plus we have a 3,000 gallon city water. So we can roll out of the fire station with over 6,000 gallons of water. Back in the old days, they looked at it, 2,000 gallons of water, so we're already gonna see improvement.
Do you think that residents will see, assuming that numbers go the way you think they will, that residents will see a difference?
They should see yes, an insurance, property insurance rates, when those go out, which ones, there's a handful. Not every insurance company uses the ISO numbers, but the majority of the ones, the bigger carriers do. And if they do see those numbers change after these people get it all done, reports are filed, they file their stuff with the insurance in the agencies, and it should reflect in their.
Would a resident need to contact their own insurance agency, or does it?
I wouldn't think they'd need to. I'll ask that when we finish up with this Mr. Crescenti. I'll ask him. If that's something they would recommend. I don't think most insurance companies would want to field thousands of phone calls from a resident saying,
right,
but
right.
Hey, I know they just did this in my town.
Right.
And
that's a good point.
They should, that's why I'm thinking he will notify them.
Okay.
And that should reflect.
Well, that would be helpful to know, because if.
Yep, well, what I think what we could do is, as a community, I mean, we can make a suggestion if people want to do that, but let them know that this project is underway and that it's going to be completed. And you may want to compare, you know, one, your annual one for this year,
yeah,
or your annual one for the preceding years to see if there was a savings, because there should be.
They won't fix something that's already in its cycle, but when you get your new policy for your new year,
correct,
that's when it will change.
Correct.
But if you're in the middle of it, you're not, they're not going to give you a rebate for 6 months.
Nope.
But they should see something the next time they get
the next time they
a
go.
Renewal
also,
update.
I mean, any time that, you know, where the town, through town meeting, you know, in our budgeting process, has managed to make an improvement that has, you know, an impact, it's nice to remind the town.
Right, and that, again, I think that ties in, because that was one of the things we were using when we were presenting information when we were going after the new vehicle, was part of that, and it's coming full circle.
Yeah.
And that new piece of equipment up here is an asset, so.
Absolutely.
New improved asset.
Yeah.
So So it should help us in the long run. I just brought that in.
Look at it.
So that project is on my desk and Kevin and I have started into it, so.
Excellent.
A lot of paperwork to do, basically, that's what most of it is, just listing what it needs, so.
Can I ask you a question?
Sure can.
I'm on a foundation that's nonprofit, and we sponsored a play at the grade school. I'm not sure you knew about Pay to Can. And so we had a meeting tonight and it was decided that we believe that going forward, we should have two firemen at every performance for safety reasons.
Okay, I understand what you're saying, probably more just because of the capacity of what the.
Capacity, exactly. The school.
The number of people that are allowed in that size.
Well, and making sure that there's clear pathways, and making sure, I mean, we can set up anything, but it means, you know, how people can go in and stuff, so is that something that you would be willing to do? And would you charge us?
That I.
I'm nonprofit. We'll talk, but it's something that you might be willing to do.
Yeah, I'm sure we'd be willing to do. Next Monday night is.
Oh, we're not having another one for another year.
Right, right.
So we get a lot of time to talk, but.
Well, if I don't start laying the groundwork now.
Yeah, we're just thinking that it's safety for everyone.
Yeah, that's a really good idea.
And like I say, you know, we can have it laid out perfectly, and then when you get a hundred people coming in, they're moving chairs and stuff, and it may not necessarily be safe. And so we need to have someone who has authority to tell them it's not safe and they can't do it, so.
When I was employed by my other entity, we used to do that all the time, that was a given when you went to, you know, like we do that festival, creating trees at Christmas time, there was somebody at high school graduation, there was members that were there. Whenever there was a large contingent, you know, people for whatever, even when they do the downtown summer plays and music festivals and stuff right there on Friday nights.
And we're allowed, yeah.
Yeah, there's a guy, just for general.
So along the same lines, I know we've asked Kevin, the room occupancy of this room.
This one right here?
This one.
Okay.
It would be, I don't think it's written anywhere, but really nice to have just a little sign.
A lot of times you do have some, yeah.
Yeah.
I'll talk to him.
Yeah.
I know he's got the paperwork for it, I don't know what the number is, but I know it's one.
He's told us before, but you know, do I remember? No, so it would be helpful to.
Oh yeah, you'll see those things a lot of times, places will have that room capacity or something.
Exactly, room occupancy, exactly, so that would be helpful.
Yeah, see what we can do about that.
Okay.
Tie in with something between that angle or Tom, and we've got a lot of people floating around making us signs, we'll see what we can do about it, getting something taken care of.
Doesn't have to be fancy.
That fancy, you just need a number.
So I'll get back to you when we start to talk about, we're gonna have our next one, it's gonna be a year from now, so, you know, don't worry. But we talked about it, you know, that's a good idea.
I'll talk about it on Monday, all the association side of things, but so it's in the minutes, so people know it's there, and they'll start the groundwork.
Pancake breakfast?
Oh yeah, pancake, yeah. It's non-charged, this is the event for a thank you to the community for.
Have you been publicizing that?
It will be.
Okay, excellent.
There's actually a couple of radio stations that contacted.
I'm sure Tia would.
Tia will do her thing, and get that information out on her different ways of doing that thing. That'll be Saturday.
Okay, excellent.
All right, very good. Nothing else for me?
Happy night.
Okay, thank you. You too. Good night all.
Town administration, so let's see if we can get through this quickly. Committee appointments, I don't think the planning board has met yet. And ZBA, Caroline, I spoke with Caroline today, I thought they were gonna need a meeting soon, because somebody was gonna do something, but I guess that never happened.
Somebody was you.
Pardon?
That was you.
What was me?
You were gonna call that meeting.
Yes, I was gonna call it when I came back from my road trip, which of course I never went on, because I decided to do this instead. And now I'm not in quite the, you know, whatever. So, but the reason that it was going to have to be done when I was on my road trip, which I never went on, was because they were expecting a an application. That application never came. So we're back to us, board, well, we were gonna do anyway, it was what I was hoping he would do. So Caroline is checking in with ZBA to see if Tuesdays from tomorrow would work. So either I'll be fine, or you can do it. It should be very short, it's just elected chair. And I did ask Caroline to ask Sarah if she could talk about process to some of the new people, or remind them that there's a handbook that's available through the state, Office of Energy and Planning and stuff. So that would be super. So she's checking, it's two Tuesdays from tomorrow, and it would be, it's like 6:30.
Yep.
That would be great, thank you. Management response, we're gonna table that. Is there anything to talk about with transfer station stickers, or did?
Well, Mike had brought it up last week, that the ordinance, it was like replacement stickers cost $5. So you, if you pay less than what you do for a sticker, but if you need a replacement, it's a $5 fee.
So you do have to, oh, okay, so if it's part of the.
That's what he said yesterday.
If it's part of the ordinance, it's part of the ordinance.
I believe that, so he said it wasn't part of the ordinance?
No, he is going to rewrite the ordinance to reflect that.
But that history said that it was then $5 for replacement.
This is our practice.
Is to charge.
Charge.
Yep, for replacement stickers.
So he's going to incorporate that into the ordinance.
Oh, okay, all right, that, yep, that's what the board decided to do, that's fine. Okay.
We didn't necessarily make a vote on that, he just said that was what the practice was.
How often does it happen, I guess?
When people get a new car or replace a car.
Or if it comes off the car for some reason, you know, falls off or whatever, you know, and you need a new one, then that's what the practice has been. I think you got that information from Kate.
Yes.
Yeah.
And there's a cost to the sticker.
Keep it on there and talk about it when it comes back.
Yeah, there is a cost to the sticker, that's true. I'm just reminded of an incident when I was a starving grad student, but it's okay, I understand. But the ordinance should reflect, I mean.
Yeah.
Right.
It should reflect.
We should leave it on there so he can explain what he's gonna do before you.
All right. The quarter one budget report, I am working on it. And numbers seem fine so far, there are a couple of things that you'll see when hopefully I'll have it next Monday. What did I notice? Caroline needs to put in needs to check in with the chart of accounts for the state DRA to get an appropriate account code for our repayment of our loans. She put her into bank fees, so it doesn't go there, so I made that change in the thing. Anything else that I noticed out of the ordinary? You know, because I don't have yet the quarter one comparison of last year, I don't know what to say about things like oil usage or that sort of thing. So, because we're a little bit over 50% for heat for most of the buildings. But that could be.
But that's kind of normal.
Yeah, that's, so, exactly. If you know, the coldest months are actually the first three, and not as cold as the last two, so. But again, that's my next step, is to do the, put in the comparison, the quarter one comparison from last year. Okay, what else, what else? The training is going on May 2nd, as far as I know. And I thought I would take the opportunity, it seems to me that once again there appears to be some contention about this budget training. I'm not sure exactly why, but once the board decided to contract with the Municipal Association for budget training for those of us who are involved in municipal budgeting, and it explains the whole basis of the municipal budget process and the RSAs and this sort of that, this thing and the other thing. I call NHMA and said, how quickly do your Wednesdays, because Wednesday seems to be the day, how quickly do your Wednesdays fill up in April and May? He says, well, you know, they get filled up. So I said, well, can you give us May 2nd? And of course, at that time, we thought the budget committee was going to meet at the beginning of April. So people have had time to sort of line things up and whatnot. And that didn't happen, so I'm sorry. I'm sorry that there are some people who feel that there's some nefarious something or other that's going on. But it's a workshop that the select board is making available to those of us who are involved in the budgeting process. And I think it would be helpful to all of us who are doing it. And we have invited people who might be in the future interested in serving on the budget committee, so that in fact, they could say that they've attended the training and, you know, they know a little bit of something. Now, the Margaret, it's, just give me a minute here. The attorney, Margaret Burns, that's kind of right. She's the one coming. And, you know, because there's sort of like attorney-client sort of kind of issues, and when we told her that there could be just members of the general public, this is the process that we're sort of thinking about doing. So, presumably I'll be here. I will be able to introduce her and introduce the format, and we'll have, like, the chairs, the people sitting at the desks at tables will be those of us who are actively involved in that. But any general public, you know, will be in the back. And we've asked people to call to let us know, again, because we don't want the venue to be over capacity. Should something come up, so the questions are going to be asked by us, the department chairs, budget committee members, select board members, people involved in budgeting. Those are the people who are going to be asking questions. The others are just, you know, just like a meeting, they're will be there. If there's a question that arises from one of us that Margaret thinks rises to the sort of a attorney-client kind of thing, she'll just say, we'll attend to that at the end. So once the workshop is over, we'll ask the public who are not officials to leave, and then we can, you know, we can go on with whatever the topic was that she thought might be best answered with public officials. I don't know what that might be.
I don't understand why that would happen, why it would happen.
Margaret brought it up.
Okay. Maybe she's been to enough to know.
Yeah. So I don't know myself. I have no clue, but, you know, we could just say that, and I'm not even anticipating something like that would happen.
Yeah.
But if it does, we'll just say, okay, we'll talk about that in part two.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, we'll ask the general public if there is any general public to leave. And,
mm-hmm.
and we'll turn off the thingy.
Mm-hmm.
But Tamara is going to be here to
yeah.
tape it.
Yeah.
So. All right.
And that's at 6:30?
6:30, yes, here.
Yep. I'll be here.
Excellent. I'm hoping to be here as well.
Yes, but I will if you come early.
Yeah, and I'll just get my song.
I can come early. Part two. I can come early if you need to.
All right. We'll be in touch.
Okay.
I have no idea about this. These grants. I know that there was something about the grants, and Caroline wasn't sure whether the board had approved the grants. I think they're for the Recreation Committee. Do you have any insight on that?
We did talk to Celia.
Yeah.
There was some that she still had to take home and check into, because a lot of them have restricted categories to make sure. So you make sure that you're gonna they were gonna be able to be part of these categories. I think the only one that we gave 100% okay was the Dick's Sporting Goods, if I remember right. The others needed work, you know. I mean, we definitely gave
yeah,
advice
you know,
for
this is,
going
this is
for
fun.
This kind of stuff and
yeah.
trying to get some money for this, but just wanted to make sure that everything was correct. And
absolutely.
Working with it.
Absolutely. And this is my line of business for like almost 30 years
mm-hmm.
at UNH.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, grant applications have stipulations.
Right.
Only certain, you know, in order to apply, you have to be a this or this or this, and you have to do. And then they have terms and conditions,
mm-hmm.
which is why I feel a board needs to be involved, because
mm-hmm.
we need to make sure that
that there's a term, that we know what these terms and conditions are, so that we're not causing the town to incur some kind of either financial liability or human resource liability, because they're restricted funds.
Right.
That they're restricted by the very nature.
What one of our comments was is that if you're applying for sporting goods stuff, basketballs, baseballs, whatever, you have to spend the money on that. That is required.
Yes.
And it isn't going to go back to the general fund.
And
so you spend the money.
It's an in a restricted fund.
Right.
And normally there's a reporting at the end of those kinds of grants.
Some
you have
grants
to show
do, yeah.
Yeah, with
yeah.
the receipts and yeah. you know, so there's a cost. There's an administrative cost to the grant making and grant receiving enterprise.
Mm-hmm.
So thank you. But the Dick's Sporting Good one seemed to be one that was.
Well, I know that she hasn't turned it in, right?
I
do
have.
You let her talk or
can I come over and speak?
Oh, sure. Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. 2 weeks.
I'm sorry. I did see that there was an email from you, but I'm not really keeping up.
So last night, the Rec Committee met. The one that was the main concern was that Walmart get grant, and the committee agrees with the select board that we are not going to go through theirs because we do not meet the qualifications for their grant funding opportunities. Instead, we will, there was in the folder of a letter that needed to be signed by the select board, and you can wait until next week.
For Dick's?
For Walmart.
We're not doing it.
To request a like gift card or donation up to $250 from the local store.
Yeah, it's the local store. She was going corporate on the other one. So the local store, you can just have a letter saying that this is, you know, for the recreation department, and they can give gift cards to be used in the store or buy food for their concession
or like get tie-dye kits.
Yeah.
Are
yeah.
they, is there financial reporting? Do we need to keep receipts?
I don't believe so.
What is
but
the,
she'll have to get more detail before we sign anything.
We have to,
yeah.
We'll put Walmart off because it's not.
She wasn't going, she was going for the big picture.
Yeah.
And this one is just local.
Okay.
Which is, it's a, you know, she was going corporate office versus.
Corporate is up to 500 or 5,000. 5,000.
Yeah.
And local is 250 or less.
Yeah. So
okay.
It's, she had a lot of categories with the corporate one.
So. The Optima Bank one I brought with me. It is all complete, and except for one thing, so I'm just going to set that aside. The one that needs to go out by tomorrow is the Dick's Sporting Goods. The committee looked at it last night and reviewed the write-up that what we were requesting for, so they changed. It says, please give us a brief history and why you would want this grant. So what the committee came up with is Camp Raleigh, our new teen camp, offers kids and teens of Rawlinsford and the surrounding communities places to go during the summer to be active and have fun. We've scheduled time slots during the week of the camps for organized sports and other athletic activities. Currently, we have some sports equipment, but definitely could use more. Some of the items we'd like to add would be nets for the soccer goals, bases for our softball field, baseball equipment, tennis accessories, and etc. Financial donations would go towards paying for transportation to the local swimming pool, state parks, and other athletic event venues, such as tennis courts and hiking trails. Any additional funds would be to offset online registration and invest in additional sports equipment.
So are those all things that they fund? Do they fund transportation? Is that one of the things they fund?
This was brought to us by another committee member who it was brought up that they do online registrations. They'll give you a grant or give you funds to provide online registration for like USA Hockey or USA Lacrosse. Other committee members have gone to Dick's and have been able to get gift cards to go in and buy. So the only questionable thing that we don't know if they would provide is the transportation at this point.
So why would you put it in your application? Why wouldn't you just buy, if you received a $500 grant, or why wouldn't you just say that that's what you're going to spend and you're going to buy this equipment and just buy the equipment completely and get away from the other part of it.
I can take that.
Because that, I think, is going to get you in trouble.
I absolutely agree with Denise, which is why I asked about that, because, you know, this is a local company, and they want to, you know, they want to get their name out. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's national, but I mean,
but it's local. Yeah.
And so they're more apt to give you equipment that they already have. You know, maybe it's last year's model, maybe it's whatever, it's a color that doesn't sell, but they could still get their tax, whatever. But it's money out the door for them paying.
Giving you a check to go somewhere else,
right.
Or whatever.
So now I haven't seen the program application. I mean, the application usually tells you, but I'm wondering about asking for the transportation too. I think you'd be
so
better off.
I can definitely take that out.
I would now stick strictly with sports equipment for anything that you're doing with, you know, baseball.
Now, does it have
baseball.
So what are the terms and conditions? What are we agreeing to do if we get these? Do we have to say on each piece of equipment something that says it was donated by Dick's? Do you know what I mean?
There's not as far as I know. They have not said anything to that effect in any of their documentation or anything like that.
Is this just an application? So if we are approved, we would still get something that we need to sign?
You mean the Board of Selectmen?
Yes.
So I'm not exactly sure because I've never applied through
that. You're applying for this grant as the Recreation Committee of the Town of Rollinsford.
Right.
Anything that, because you're an entity of Town of Rollinsford, you are under our umbrella.
That's correct.
And you can't sign for your own,
right.
Asking for monies and stuff. So I would say that we would have to sign something that says that we're accepting this grant under these terms and conditions.
Like if you're at the University of New Hampshire, you know, if you're a faculty member or a research scientist or whatever, you can't submit your grant on your own. It has to go through. There's a central office, and that central office reviews the application terms to make sure that, in fact, you know, you can apply. Because sometimes they only do it to small colleges, sometimes they only do it to historically black universities and colleges. You know, so they have to make sure that you know that this application works. And the really important thing that they look at is what are the commitments that the university is making once the grant comes in, because you don't want to submit a grant and you've got a 50% match and you've got nowhere to find that 50%. So not saying that's part of it, I'm just saying, you know, what Denise and I are saying, that's why the select board, you know, needs to be involved in the grant making thing to make sure that the town is protected. So this has to be done tomorrow?
The sooner the better. They're requesting 60 days notice. And so last Wednesday was 60 days prior to the first day of camp.
It's still within the 60 days. You can go and get stuff in July and use it for the rest of it. And it's going to go to the next year's camp, too. So it's not like it's gone. It's no use anymore because you're going to store it and keep it, you know.
But that's part of also, I mean, I wonder if you would be able to kind of maybe take a gander at that, because sometimes one of the reasons you have to market is that because they don't want to give you something, and then at the end of the program, you end up selling it. You've got some, you know, you end up with a yard sale, and you start selling off this equipment. So who maintains, while we maintain the property rights to this equipment, we may also be saying that we have to continue to use it for those purposes for, I don't know. I mean, the feds have that for, property. Anything that the university, for example, gets from the federal governments, it's marked. And, you know, the feds come in and will audit the fixed assets that they have. And we better find it. We better know where they are.
Yeah.
And so, you know, these are basketball, so it's not quite the same thing as an electronic.
No, and things get broken,
whatever,
and,
but,
you know.
But there could be some terms and conditions, and what are they?
When is your next meeting?
May 20th.
You should have one before that. Only because if we're going to go forward and you have a deadline to have it in 60 days, I will review what you sent to the Rec Committee. I will also go online to see if I can see any conditions that you might have not seen. And then we need to I think you need to have a meeting, or at least with your chairs and you and me.
Yeah.
And talk about it and be more clear about what we're what our obligations are to this. And so, can you talk to your chairs and see if we can meet?
Yes. So, along with the Dix grant, as we're conversing, I'm thinking maybe I should reevaluate. I had originally put that we were requesting $250 as their donation to us, as our top priority to receive, and then they give you three priority choices, so the top priority would be $250. Second choice would be equipment donation up to $600, so we could go into the store and get that baseball ball.
So cash versus product is what you're saying in the first one. But wouldn't the expectation be that if they gave you cash, that it would be going into their store and buying the product from them with the cash? Okay.
So I'm rethinking which one is better.
Well, I think, isn't it easier for a vendor to say,
this is what we have to offer, and what can you use out of the, you know, or give you a gift card, you know, because maybe you want 20 baseballs and one basketball, you know, so I'm sorry, I would be surprised if, I would aim for, well, this is personally, I would aim for either gift cards so you can go into the store and buy what you need to buy, or then donating supplies, and this is the areas in which you need.
Yeah.
You know, and then, because I think
they don't want to give you $200, and then you're going to go out to
Walmart.
You
know? Yeah. I mean, that's not the intention of them. They want to bring people into their store and buy stuff because they gave you money. Then they want you to come back and keep on coming back.
And one of their questions is, are you interested in receiving other, I think it's fundraising emails or something like that.
Okay, so they're gonna want to maybe.
Yeah, see, we need to know what. Yeah,
they might do. They might do like, you know, like some of these restaurants are doing, and you come between this hour and this hour, and we get so much proceeds to your organization. They may do the same thing on May 2nd. We'll give so much percentage to your organization, and people come in and have a paper. You know, so that's what they might be.
So. And I've done that with other organizations that they support.
Mm-hmm.
Where was I? I lost my train of thought. So Dix, the sooner the better. And then the other one, it just came out today, is Eastern Bank. And they also have a 60-day requirement. And I have a copy of our application, and then there's a copy in everybody's email too. Looking for feedback.
Is that what you sent, like, today or something?
I sent a couple of them this afternoon.
All right, I'll
look at that too.
So
those are cash, clearly. That and Optima Bank is cash. Clearly.
This is up to $500 from Eastern Bank. They have several, but for community organizations, it's up to $500. And they have done, like, the City of Lynn. They've helped. Done different things there, and so they've done other municipalities, from what I found.
Are they around here?
There's one in Dover.
There is an Eastern Bank.
Central Avenue across from People's Bank. It took over.
It's the Dunkin' Donuts.
So, this was the one I was working on last week that wasn't ready. They have to have a person in charge of the organization. And so that would be you guys.
It would be us guys. Yeah.
So they have your emails to contact slipboard.rollinsford@rollinsford.unh. Yep. And they needed one person as the head of the organization. And so,
surprise!
So your name is going to be the name used because you're the chairman of the slip. I wanted to inform you of that.
Well, thank you. If I am ignoring something that you think I shouldn't ignore, have Caroline call me.
Yes. They also have the main email that they will be using, from what I understand, is the rec committee, which will go to the whole rec committee. And so, but they needed to have the authority figure, the main person as contact.
Well, do you want me to be the contact, since I'm the... I'm the delegate to the rep.
Fine with me.
And then I can talk with you about the other one.
That's absolutely fine with me.
So have me be instead of Suzanne.
I can change that.
Okay.
Good, thank you.
Well, just because it's, I'm the delegate anyway, so.
Yeah, makes sense. Very good.
So I'll review them once from like, that you have sent out and give you my feedback on those. I've dealt with a lot of grant writing, so I understand.
Have you really?
I mean, my husband wrote a grant for the fire truck that we got for free.
Oh.
Tankers.
Good to know.
Yeah.
How excellent.
Yeah.
You know, also, usually for these small kinds of grants, there isn't an administrative overhead. But to the extent that they allow administrative overhead, mm-hmm. we should consider putting that in, you know, even if it's just 5%, mm-hmm. you know, 5%, 10%.
Yeah. So I will review them and then I'll give you my feedback on that. And we, I really believe on Dick's, you should go with equipment or gift card versus cash. That's my opinion.
And no transportation.
So no transportation.
So I've already, I'll take the transportation out. As you recommend, and I think it was recommended by one of the other committee members to do cash, because that's what they had talked to somebody else about. And Dick's has two different grants that they give out, one to sports teams that are starting and one to community nonprofit organizations.
I mean, you can find out who their program officer is, you know, whoever is in charge of these kinds of things, just ask them, are we more apt to be successful asking for cash, or more apt to be successful asking for blah blah blah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's a good idea. I just think it's easier for them to take stuff off the shelf and back
me too.
Carrier and give you that stuff versus, you know, handing over the cash.
So Optima Bank was okay, but they reviewed it last week and said at that point it looked okay. We have until May 31st for them, and that'll give us a decision June 15th, which is 10 days before the camp starts. However, Optima Bank is requesting, they suggest supplementary information, which I added in, except for the budget. I'm waiting for the chairperson of my committee to get me the budget to add in to review that. But they're all in your email, and I have paper copies here if anybody would like the paper.
No, I'll look on my email. It's easier for me. I said I'll look on my email. It's easier for me.
I'll actually take the paper.
Yeah, that's easier for you.
How low I have fallen.
I know. So I'll do it this week, and I will get in touch with you as soon as possible.
And
I will email
the chairs and see if we can schedule a meeting.
You kind of need to have just a kind of like a follow-up on that, you know, before we all sign on the Walmart one at least, well, or on any of them, just to make to go through and make sure I understand what all your requirements are.
But I appreciate
hard work, a lot of hard work. Absolutely.
And the other thing that we discussed last week, and we were alluding to it, is that instead of getting money when things are donated, that pictures get taken, and at the end of the season or the beginning of next year, we send out thank you cards. With the pictures in them. I did that last year for Target and a couple other places. So they got to see actually what they,
that's very nice.
What they donated to the program.
I think that's good.
So like we got a kiddie pool at Walmart or Target. So that way they know exactly where their funds went.
That's great. Thank you, Celia.
Good job.
All right, SRPC. Have I mentioned this?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we know what this is about. So I do have something to add to this. So, you know, when Cynthia Copeland, who is now retired as the executive director of Stratford Regional Planning Commission, came to us on her farewell tour, mm-hmm. you know, when we talked about the village and infrastructure, she said, well, you know, you really should do a visioning, blah, blah, blah. So this is justified information for us. James, is it Burdeen, Judy? Is that how
Burdeen.
James Burdeen is their economic development guy. He's a really, really smart guy, really, really nice guy. So he's going to come to us on the 14th. He was concerned, when I had my initial conversation with him, he was concerned about, you know, we're not committed to anything, but, you know, if we, in talking to him, we said,
Yeah, we would like to write an RFP to get a visioning thing, you know, so maybe for next year's town meeting. Can you help us with the RFP? And he said, well, if I help you with the, I don't want to help you with the RFP if then I can't apply, if SRPC then can't respond. So I talked to the Municipal Association, and they, and it was Stephen Buckley I spoke to, and he had just talked to his regional planning commission, I don't remember what it is, whoever does Concord, and they build firewalls. So they have somebody in the regional planning commission that will help write the RFP. It has nothing to do with that group in the planning commission that would respond. And at the very time that he was telling me that, either Cynthia or James wrote to me, James wrote to me and said, by the way, I mentioned this to Cynthia Copeland before she actually left, and Cynthia said, in the past, what they have done is build firewalls, and they've had one person, you know, do that. It has nothing to do with the people who might respond. So that's two sources. So I think, because I would hate to exclude SRPC, because they might be a, you know, a really good resource to actually do the visioning if it's something that we decide to do. The other thing that I have done is I've asked Jackie Schroeder to, I told Jackie Schroeder, who is a new resident in town, that we were going to be doing this night, and if she was interested, just to come and listen. She is energetic, smart, PR and marketing person. So if there's, you know, stuff that could be happening down the road, she's also on the Conservation Commission, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. So if there's stuff, you know, this might be something that could light her fire, you know. And
cool.
So she's just coming to listen, and if you haven't met her yet, she's a really wonderful young woman. So that's the only thing I needed to say about that. Tabling the grant, Conservation Commission funds, what was that about?
Remember we were questioning where they were and stuff? I guess they've always, the checkbook's always been in the safe.
Okay.
It always has
so
been there,
right,
and it's there now,
along,
and it's all along, it's in the safe.
Okay.
So that's where they are.
The only other thing that I did a very little amount of research to, and there are different types of Conservation Commission funds. So, and to be honest with you, I don't know whether, you know, these are like forest, I don't know that we have any special funds. So how I would look at that is say, well, we'll just assume that it's the most restricted fund,
mm-hmm.
and we'll be the safest.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And we don't know it, and I think people on the Conservation Commission have started to look to see how should the money be handled.
Mm-hmm.
Should the treasurer, should they go to the town treasurer and not so much the Conservation Commission treasurer? What are the rules and regs associated with that money? Because right now there's left like almost $40,000.
Oh, wow.
They got it from the timber clearing that they did around Turcotte Field and Scoutman.
Mm-hmm.
So there's quite a bit of money.
Mm-hmm.
And so it behooves them to learn how to, you know, learn the rules and regs about how to use it.
Yeah.
Now, I know they can't do their own contracts. That's why, you know, Al has come to us with contracts for
mm-hmm.
whatever. Like they did some clearing and invasive species. And so we sign the contracts because, again, the town is essentially liable. But, you know, anything other than that, I don't really know. But I think there are going to be some people on the Conservation Commission who are going to spend some time to help figure that out so that we work it. And they did that wonderful cleanup on
that was great. That was great.
Road, so.
Yeah.
The only thing I copied the board on this as well. It, that cleanup was not planned at a Conservation Commission meeting. It wasn't even mentioned at the Conservation Commission
mm-hmm.
meeting. So my piece of advice was, look, what you did was absolutely 100% to the good of the community.
Mm-hmm.
It was engaged, you got people in. Excellent. Just be careful how you talk about it, because it wasn't sponsored by the Conservation Commission, because that would have had to have happened at a public meeting that had been
posted. So, but you can say things like individuals from the Conservation Commission decided to organize this, and that's perfectly fine. So it's a subtlety, but you know, for those, when we start to get into municipal government, you know, people who are new to it, you know, we have to learn all of these quirks so that, you know, this was, you know, I don't know that anybody could find any fault what happened there, but sometimes, you know what I mean? Things happen.
Exactly.
Things happen, so I did send that off along to them. Tabling the twice meeting, Mike is doing her perambulation, so we'll wait till he returns, and I guess it's folder work. So there are two pieces that we really need to attend to.
Okay.
Right, there's the, we have to sign the DRA. Should be there with a title, with a signature page.
Got it.
That looks like it, right.
Yes.
Okay. I printed out two copies, I don't think we need two copies, but. So what's gonna happen, once we sign it, it's sufficient to have the two of us sign it, is we'll scan it and upload the signed copy to the DRA. Because it's not sufficient that we do it on the portal. We then have to print it, sign it, and ship it back up. It's not the most efficient way to manage these things, but, you know.
That is being held until another meeting.
Yeah, that was the letter she was referring to.
Oh, okay.
For us to sign it based on.
Okay, well, we're not gonna.
No, we're not gonna do it, but we had it, I just didn't know it's going here. So, okay, so we have to sign or.
Yes, so shall I say what this is?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so there are many reports that we have to do to the DRA, the Division of Revenue Administration that manages the monies that the town spends and sets our tax rate. And so we submitted the budget to them before town meeting with what the select board recommended and what the budget committee recommended, our various warrant articles, and again, whether for the financial ones, whether the select board recommended or the budget committee recommended. So now what we have to do is report to them the appropriations as voted on at town meeting. And they are essentially what the select board, if you looked at the select board recommendation, they're essentially that plus $1 for the, because we had to amend the petition warrant.
Right.
So that's what we're signing.
Yes. Do you want to sign first?
I don't care, but I will. And then we'll leave it in the folder. Do you have post-its?
Do I have post-its?
Do you have post-its?
I do in the office. Do you want to go get them?
Nah, we'll just, Caroline will, she'll figure it out.
But you want my signature, or you just need the two of us?
No, a quorum. I mean, it would be nice, but I mean, we're already late.
Mm-hmm, okay. With the second of all. Now, this annual post-closure report, do you know about that? This, I don't know if it was last week or the week before. This is about the landfill, the previous landfill that's out there.
Oh, yeah, we're supposed to report.
Yeah,
so it's not filled out.
I think we were actually waiting for George and I to go in the folder.
Yes.
Now, why don't we go ahead and wait and on the agenda for.
Yep.
Are you doing the agenda thing?
Just put a note, put for homework assignment, just that I have to add the, whatever that is, post-closure.
Post-closure report for the transfer station. And put George, so we know that he's here to talk about that. Because Mike will be back next week?
I think so.
I think so, too. 100%.
Yeah.
All right, let me see what this is. It's a letter from from Shiprock Waste Solutions. It's talking about recycling and I'm not sure.
Any change in price?
Effective January 1st, plastic bags will no longer be acceptable in a single sort load.
What do that?
It's time for alternate methods to put them in place for your facility.
Maybe we should ask Caroline to try to get a clarification.
Plastic bags will no longer be acceptable in a single sort. We're talking about plastic garbage bags?
Mm-hmm. We don't put. So I don't know what.
This is recycling, so we don't.
Unless they.
Maybe people do, I don't know.
Normally, you know, plastic bags filled with stuff are going into the municipal solid waste, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, do they mean you can't throw your Hanover plastic bags in the single stream recycling?
Right.
Or do they mean you can't put a bag of aluminum cans in the single stream recycling? I don't know what they might mean, so we need some clarification.
But it's also, it's due to recent changes in the recycling industry, the costs that are being inflicted on the waste management industry, Shipyard Waste is being forced to access a modest fee of $30 per ton on an all single sort recycling loads.
So they're going to be 30 bucks more per load. So, you know, the recycling commodities have been roller coastering, but actually in this kind of a way, you know, going like that.
Yeah.
So it's not surprising. Mm-hmm. Again, we'll ask Caroline to verify pretty much what it means for us. And one of the things that that I'll report to the board when we review the budget is the need for any kind of budget revisions. You know, you've become familiar with that from being a member of the budget committee.
Mm-hmm.
So,
mm-hmm.
So we may feel, depending on what she finds out, that we have to do this. I've heard that they're getting fussier. I've heard that folks that sort these single stream things
mm-hmm.
are getting fussier about what they get.
Oh.
So I mean, but I've just read that generally.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Mm-hmm.
And while we're talking about this, I know that Lamprey Regional was having a meeting. And they were having a hard time finding a quorum. Is Caroline going?
I think that's what Mike was saying, whether or not Caroline or George would go. I don't know if anybody ever said anything to them to put them together.
I did talk to Caroline.
Okay. Did she say she was going?
Yes.
Okay.
She said. This was my own opinion, you know, which you're certainly welcome to disagree with. I told Caroline, it's fine for both of you to go. I would like you, Caroline, to be there, because they're gonna be talking money.
Mm-hmm.
They're gonna be talking money about mm-hmm. the truck. They're gonna be talking money about depending on what the bids are.
Mm-hmm.
How does it get paid back over what span of time? So I want to make sure that Caroline is there to kind of. Capture all of that and ask
okay.
some good questions. Is that?
I'm okay with that.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah.
I told her she'd bring George if she thinks that would be helpful.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. Okay.
So I guess it's not us that aren't forming the quorum then, because they were still trying to find enough people.
Right. Right.
Okay.
Yeah, she wasn't against begging or pleading or
that's
something.
That's what it was. Yes.
We did have a PO in here. PO number 1428 Intuit. Laser Secure Plus voucher check for checking account.
Say what? Who submitted it?
No one. There's no name.
Oh. Can I take a look
okay,
at
so,
it?
So.
Is that $25 shipping?
Yeah. Oh, there's nothing there.
There's nothing here.
Well, look down here though. Maybe that's the same. Which one you would pick? Maybe.
So there's $1,000 about...
1,000 quantity.
1 year of laser.
About a year's worth is 368.
Oh,
and then 2,000 would be 2 years worth of 5,786. They're checks.
These are checks.
Voucher checks for checking account. Okay.
I don't know why they're called voucher checks. I think we're running out of checks.
Okay.
And I remember an email conversation that Caroline had with her.
Okay. So for a year, it would be about a year's worth would be 1,000, would be $368.99. And for 2,000, for about 2 years worth, would be $576.99. So it's less for 2 years.
She was, you know, she said, Vern, are you going to, you know, be looking around for some other?
Do you think he did this, or is it this Caroline?
I have no, I really don't know the answer to that. So maybe we should find out.
Is it more info needed?
Yeah. I mean, if Vern is serious about looking for other options.
Oh, you mean like bank options? Oh, yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. And I sent to him information on what we call PDIP. That's the New Hampshire Public Deposit Investment Pool. They're the ones, we open up accounts there for our, to deposit our loan proceeds, so that we can have a pure audit trail, a really good audit trail. And when we opened up those PDIP accounts, the woman who was our resource said, well, you know, we used to manage your cash, you know, our general fund, as we did for many other municipalities and still do. Mm-hmm. And I think when, you know, interest rates went down to, like, you know, practically negative amounts, I don't know why we ended up with Citizens. But, so I just told Vern, I said, well, you know, PDIP does cash management. They'll do general fund. So I don't know how interested he is. It could have been just a passing comment. But that would affect, the reason I'm bringing it up is it would affect whether we were going to buy 1 year or 2 years.
Well, I put a note, more info needed, who submitted, is the new treasurer considering a bank change?
Perfect.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right. All right, so we won't vote on that tonight.
Yep.
Okay. Here's the Citizens one. So this is, who's approved by signing? Check is in the checkbook. This is a check. This is the Citizen one, and it's saying signing the check is in the folder, which I signed. There is a charge for Amazon Prime. I will be disputing it.
Good, which he should be disputing.
Yep.
But if you sign, one of us needs to authorize, though, the payment on the
these,
credit
card. Okay.
Yes. So if you wanted to quickly take a look at it, you know, usually what I do is just say, ensure that, unless it's Caroline, that the individual amounts are within 200.
Okay.
And that they're not for alcohol.
But she would have.
Yeah.
Just saying. Oh, this is one big... Oh no, it goes down by degrees.
It's into sections.
Okay, so this is like the whole bill, and then this is individual.
Yes, so it's you can look at it any way you want. Is that the prime one? That's
the prime one is on George.
You know, I think what happens, because it happens if the fire department, it's just so easy to just click. You know, you don't know what you're clicking, and all of a sudden you've signed up for Prime.
But why wouldn't we sign up for Prime? That gives you free shipping on everything. I'm just asking.
Yeah, I don't have an answer.
Oh, okay.
Talk to Caroline and see if it's a good idea, whether it covers everybody under this.
Oh, if it's just the town, it would cover everybody.
You know, every credit, is it?
I mean, do we buy a lot off at Amazon?
I don't really know. She might be able to tell you.
Okay. Because, I mean,
it does
give you free
$60 a year?
It's, I'd say it's 150.
Right.
It's going up to 100.
So,
is it 100?
So somebody, somebody should,
business,
you know.
If it's a business, it's nothing?
There may be
$3
million.
What was it on here?
They charge us.
Well, they charge us for what?
It's not a business.
$12.99.
It's a month.
$12.99.
You took out a monthly.
Prime, Amazon Prime membership, $12.99. If that's it, you're going to save that in postage.
Yeah.
However, I mean, there might be reasons why
here's the order. What was it for? Emergency beacon warning hazard flashing strobe light. So, although it didn't pay any shipping in hand, oh, because it signed them up for product.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, you know, somebody should, you know, run the numbers and come up with a proposal. Is it a good idea? Is it not a good idea?
Yeah, because it's any bundle recovery light bar for $134.99. So, I mean, looks like we're, at least the highways, there's the pictures of them. But it looks like the highways are using it.
So, if I wouldn't mind you chatting with Caroline about
okay.
that.
Okay, all right. I think I'll do that, just to find out.
Yeah, and you can let us know.
If we do it through the town, then it should affect any town.
If that is true, then that may indeed make sense.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, now, you know, the credit card is still reasonably new,
mm-hmm.
as you know.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, as department heads get used to using Amazon, it may well come in handy.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I know that there's some things that you can definitely get much cheaper. If you have the time to wait for it to come,
yeah.
you know, but
and she can do up to 400.
Okay, is that good? Okay, he says Kevin. What is Mr. Hurd have? What is his amount? Buyer
two.
Okay. Each time?
Yeah. Everyone has two except for Caroline.
Okay.
So what I would do then,
yeah,
Denise,
I mean, okay.
is, you know, you'll talk to her about the...
Yep.
So, on the original, now whatever the first cover page is that the first cover page?
I wonder if this is it, because this is like the whole,
yeah.
the whole bill.
So the whole bill,
yeah.
if you see that for just a moment,
mm-hmm.
what,
make sure the check is for that much.
Okay, so on the new balance, so here's where I would sign. Right. I don't
okay.
sign up here because this is what she's going to return
you
have to
me. Return it.
So I sign here, just
okay.
name and date.
1568 56 is it
1568? Yep. So I would just sign it, date it,
okay.
and that's what Tom, our auditor, you know, if there isn't a PO, he looks to make sure that there's a paper trail where the board has in fact looked at it.
Because. Well, there are only department heads have these, right? Or
yes,
department
yes
head
and no.
is approving something.
So for the fire department, because the person who actually does the purchasing is the assistant or the deputy, whatever
assistant,
it is.
Yeah,
Kevin.
Yeah.
He's the one who has the card.
Yeah.
Otherwise,
but he's a department head, though,
yeah.
Technically.
Okay.
I mean
right.
he's not the chief, but he's yeah, so I would say that's
yeah.
okay. Yeah.
So that's that.
Mm-hmm.
It's Chief Ducharme for fire. There's one in the front office, either Kate or Andrea,
mm-hmm.
Caroline,
yeah.
Richard
okay.
for here, and George.
Okay. So even though you said the credit lines are 200, is that what did you say?
200 per person for purchase.
Oh, per person. Okay, because I said the credit line is higher than that.
There is
okay.
a monthly, there's also a monthly limit, which we can change pretty readily if we felt we wanted to,
okay.
per person. And then there's also an overall limit for the town.
Okay.
I don't remember exactly what they are, but you can ask Caroline.
We have $1,000.
That could be
per
person.
Per card.
Per card,
yeah.
yeah. Per month.
Okay, so I did sign that, and that was the check.
Good.
We're good,
perfect.
Right?
Yep.
Okay.
Do I put
it in?
Sure. Yes.
I put it in.
You know, I have yet to figure out what these folders are. There's like all these folders, and you can find a purchase order in any one of them.
Okay, so we're going to get more information on that PO.
Yeah.
And that's it.
That is all I have.
That's excellent, including correspondence, right?
That is, yes.
That's it.
We cleaned out the folder last week.
Oh, good, you actually went.
Yes, ma'am.
I'd like to say something about that.
About cleaning out the folder?
Yes.
Okay.
Because I mentioned to Caroline that it's a problem.
What's a problem?
Well, there was.
To keep having stuff over and over again. Well, her problem is she doesn't know that it's been looked at.
Okay.
So what should we do?
Well, she wants.
Post-its.
We should make sure we have post-its.
But I said to her, when I'm done with something, I initial it.
I think that's what I'll do.
So we can just put a post-it that says file.
Or I'll toss in my initials or file my initials.
Yeah.
Because some of it, you don't really need to file.
Yeah.
It's like a notification from, you know, Comcast or something like that, you know. But I will start doing that.
She needs that feedback in order to.
Thank you for that.
Thank you for checking on that for me. Because we went through and put a note on there that these can be filed now. Because I kept on being there week after week, so. And these go to Caroline too, right? These POs.
POs, yeah.
And this one as well.
Yep.
Okay. Oh, yeah. This is going to be brought back up on this reporting thing because we're going to talk to.
All right, so the other thing I would like to mention is that I thought we closed the PDIP accounts. You know, the ones with the, these were the ones where we were, we put the proceeds of our loans. And the funds were taken out to cover the projects. But we earned interest, so that interest is still sitting there. So I thought we'd ask Beverly to close them. Maybe we did, maybe we didn't, I don't know, but they weren't closed. So I pulled down the last statement for all, because each one had their own, so three, transfer station, the culverts, and the fire engine. And I filed it on Google Drive. You can, if you want to look at them, you can just Google, you know, search for NHPDIP. And there's also then the request form to close out the account. So what we're going to do is close out the account. All of those, they call it dividends on interest. The dividends will come back into the general fund, so she'll have to put the bank statement and stuff. And I've asked her to check with Vern, because currently the only two people authorized to do that are me and Beverly. So
it names it Beverly, not the treasurer. It names it Beverly.
It is named Beverly. So if Vern, ask Vern. I mean, if he's fine with my just signing it, and it goes into the general fund. He has the same. That's fine. If he actually wants to do it, then that's fine too. He'll just have to fill out whatever forms that they'll ask him to fill out in order to make it be it. So
okay,
that's that. All right. I don't have anything else. Any community input? Yay. I think we can go.
Motion to adjourn. Whoops, we know.
We just by overwhelming consent.
Yes, you did really well.
Thank you.
So, you feeling okay? You're going to get up.
Yeah, no, I am. Actually, I'm feeling a little better than I was like 10 minutes ago. Oh, just something. It's the way you sit. It's the way you
move. The way you move.
The way you move is, it's difficult to